Peace. How's everybody doing? This is the guy, Anti-Simp, back with a new video. And I want to talk about pretty much what everybody's been talking about. And that is the news that Kevin Samuels had passed away. I know he passed away back in the early parts of May. I think it was pretty much the first week of May. I think it was like May 4th. And when I got the news, I wasn't even too sure, you know. When I got the news, I think I was, you know, just getting up from a long nap or whatever, you know. And my homeboy hit me up, and my homeboy, who wasn't even a follower, he just told me, you know. And I didn't want to believe it at first, you know. So I kind of went around social media, you know. The first time, every time I hear like the death of somebody, you know, I tend to go to the to Twitter or whatever, because it's like the most updated and more reliable than Facebook. The Facebook interface is just, I like a lot. Like, I like using Facebook when it comes to like social media, because it's like you're on a website and you have your own personal blog within the website. So you have your profile, and which is what everybody pretty much has. The profile is pretty much, it's almost like, you know, you're your own person, you're your own, it's your profile. You know, you have pages and you have profile. Pages represent like, you know, your blog. You know, you can post videos and podcasts and, you know, merchandise up there. So it's like you have your own personal websites within the websites. It's actually kind of genius if you think about it. Kind of like how Amazon has, you know, sellers up there, and it's like the retail. It's like the Walmart of the internet. They all have their own personal sellers. At first, they probably didn't even have their own items up there. Most of the items that were sold by other sellers. But now, you know, it's pretty much become the Walmart of the internet. One of the biggest, richest retail on the internet. But anyway, but the Manosphere is pretty much mourning the loss of Kevin Samuels. He was a big part of the Manosphere. I know females are out here talking about, y'all daddy died, now what, you know, and, you know, y'all king is dead, now what y'all gonna do? And, you know, they laughing, you know, they're celebrating. But it was like the primary audience that Kevin Samuels had was females. You know, it was females that was calling in. It was females that was watching his show. He talked about men for 3 years and nobody really gave a shit about it. You know what? That's not entirely true. I'm not gonna say nobody gave a shit, because he was close to 100,000 followers when I noticed that he was talking about guys. When I went back to his profile to see that he was talking about guys, he was like, you know, at least had 100,000 followers. But, you know, talking about women did help, you know, boost his channel to 2 million subscribers. I mean, he simultaneously had 2 million subscribers on YouTube, and his Instagram was checkmarked as well at 1 million followers, so probably more by now. But when I got the news, I didn't want to believe it. I got the news, I was like in disbelief or whatever. I was about to head to the gym, and I'm like, you know, I'm looking on Twitter, I'm just trying to, you know, see if this is accurate. And I thought he was a big name, but I wasn't too sure if, like, you know, a media outlet like TMZ would report it. But, you know, I'm looking around, I'm seeing other media outlets reporting it, but they're not really that credible. So, and this could be somebody's cruel idea of a joke, because, you know, it's the black community. You know, if they're going to do anything else, they're going to be villainous to their own folks. And I don't even like when people say stuff like that, but the fact that, you know, he was villainized as if he was like Hitler or something, that's just really interesting how much his content has like emotionally triggered people, especially females, you know. But I went to the gym, I tried to clear my mind, because, you know, the death of somebody, of a black person, especially when they're doing like positive things, it can hurt, you know. Like when Kobe Bryant died, you know, that kind of hurt, you know, that kind of hurt a lot. When Shaq Gaspar died, that kind of hurt a lot. You know, when Prince died, Charlie Murphy, those type of guys, when they died, you know, they were still, you know, they died really soon, you know, they died too soon. you know, I mean, the way they died is also, you know, it sucks as well, but the fact that they died too soon was just, it kind of hurt, because these are people that, well, I wasn't a basketball fan, so, you know, Kobe Bryant wasn't like a hero to me, but I know he was a hero to somebody. You know, I wasn't a follower of Kevin Samuels. I didn't religiously like tune into his shows every day or whatever the case is. I would check it out every once in a while whenever he posts them, but you know, I wasn't, you know, like a huge follower. But my thing is, I'm happy to see black men doing positive things. So to see black men doing positive things, being successful, and then they die really soon, and then they die like horrible deaths, it kind of hurts. I can't elaborate too much more on why it hurts, because I don't know why. I don't have an answer, but it did hurt. You know, it was something that, you know, that sucked. So the rest of the day sucked. You know, I ended up finding out that my Twitter was it was suspended for like 3 weeks before I found out about the news. So when I went to go check on Twitter, they wouldn't tell me anything unless I logged in, because my Twitter account has been suspended since April. So I went up there to try to find out, you know, news on Twitter, and I forgot I was logged out. I logged back in, come to find out I got my Twitter account restored. But you know, the rest of the day sucked because of the news about him, and I still wasn't too sure. I went around to his, you know, other YouTube channels to find out if the news was, you know, real or not. I went to other people that talked about him or knew about him or had interacted with him to see if, you know, what they said was, if they knew anything, like BGS or O'Shea, Dennis Sperling. And for the most part, I know O'Shea left a message up there, but it was, it didn't really give much detail. He was like, he was waiting on, you know, he was like he was waiting to hear. And then BGS, he was kind of, he didn't say anything either. I get to the gym, and then, you know, I'm about almost finished with my workouts or whatever, and then I'm still looking around to I was supposed to be using the gym to take my mind off of these things, but you know, I just kept thinking about it. So I get to pulling up the YouTube channels, and you know, BGS is like, you know, putting up, you know, tribute videos, and I'm like, nah, maybe he's doing this too soon. But then, like, it should have sunk in that if, you know, Kevin was a social media user, so if people were reaching out to him, he would have like done a live by now. He would have, you know, if my memory serves me correctly, whenever he used to do his live streams or whatever, or when he's about to schedule a live stream, he would, you know, notify people if there was going to be a show or not. So that should have been an indicator that, you know, something was wrong. But I still was, you know, hoping that, you know, nothing bad was happening to him, because like I said, man, it sucks when somebody's positive and they're doing great things. Even I don't care what anybody else says, he didn't deserve any of the hate he got. So for somebody like him to like pass away, it just sucked. And you know, females are out here talking about, you know, when he's gone now, what y'all gonna do? They like reveling in it, like, you know, almost as if they were acknowledging how much of what he was saying was accurate, how much it was bothering them, that they were looking in the mirror every day at themselves, seeing that they weren't gonna get what they wanted, no matter how badly they wanted it. So the real question is, it's not towards what we're gonna do, because, you know, Kevin's whole talking points, a lot of his talking points came from the men. You know, he was always saying he was talking on behalf of the men. So if his talking points came before us, if his talking points came from us, then we're gonna always be all right. You know, somebody else will use those same talking points and create their own channel, and they'll have some success as well, because this is pretty much something that you could actually be successful off of, because he was successful off of it, and there's other guys in the Manosphere who are successful off of this as well. BGS is an example. O'Shea definitely blew up his channel. You also have what's his name? I forget his name, because he was Minister Jap. He was also somebody also that's successful. You have Mediocre Tutorials, The Poor Man's Podcast. Those type of guys have gained success. Dennis Sperling, the attorney boy, I forgot his name. I forget his name, but you know what I'm talking about. The attorney boy, Dennis Sperling is an attorney, but you also have the other guy who's an attorney as well. I forget what his name is. He's a dark skinned brother. He's been doing pretty well. He's the one that Tasha K lashed out at. Let me see. let me see. I don't think I got it. I don't think I got it right now. But he's an example of somebody who was, who's also starting to get, you know, really successful because his subscriber count is going up. I think he reached 100 million of subscribers. You got guys like Sinful to P, who's gained success as well. So you have a whole bunch of guys within the parameters of the Manosphere, and they're doing really well. You got Tashawn Johnson, Dr. Tashawn Johnson. Many of these guys are doing well. Ron Wills, many of these guys are doing extremely, extremely well. They're doing really well for themselves. And, you know, what can you say, man? What else can you say? Cousin T-Tall, definitely. Authentic Alphas are doing their thing. Many of these guys out here, the lead attorney, that's his name. I can't believe I forgot his name. But these guys are out here doing really well within the Manosphere or within the area of the Manosphere. Because I know you probably would consider Sinful to P as a guy of the Manosphere because, you know, he talk about the game. So, you know, the Manosphere is pretty much talking about square shit. But I didn't mean to go that far off of the points I'm trying to make. So the real question that females need to ask themselves is, what are they gonna do? Kevin Samuels was the only one trying to help y'all, and y'all pretty much glad he's dead. You know, the black community to me was hanging on by a thread, and I know nobody else will probably believe this, but you know, you're gonna start to see this stuff. If you were ignoring it for a while, you're gonna start to see it probably in the next five years or so. I was gonna say 10 years, but that's what I was saying 5 years ago. So, and 5 years ago, I was saying in the next 5 to 10 years. So, you're probably going to start to see, like, I mean, unless the inflation somehow magically brings black people back together, which I doubt because, you know, motherfuckers should have felt the effects of the pandemic in 2020 and 2021. But, you know, it is what it is. But the black community was hanging on by a thread. And he was the only one that was actually cared enough to sit around arguing with broads 5 days a week for 2 to 4 hours, giving them a platform so they can talk, and he was talking to them and pretty much using his platform to tell them things that we've been saying for a while, and they still weren't listening. At some point I actually stopped watching the show, not because of him, but because the broads, no matter what they looked like, were all saying the same things. It didn't matter if it was a lawyer or a doctor or a businesswoman, or a chick who, you know, was a struggling actress or whatever. It didn't matter what they were or what they were doing. They were all saying the same crap. And Patrice O'Neal has said this before as well. He said he's dated doctors and lawyers and all types of broads who have, you know, certifications or professionalism to them. And they all say the same crap. So, but they all think that they're different. They all think that none of this stuff could apply to them because they think that they're all different. They think there's individualism. Which is interesting to me because they all have this mentality of all, you know, every woman, that they are every woman. And realistically, you know, you should really be worried about yourself. But the real question is, what are they going to do when he's gone? I mean, since he's gone, since not when he's gone, my bad. What are they going to do now that he's gone? And now that, you know, there's a void, there's nobody else that's going to sit up here trying to have these conversations with y'all. They're going to feel like he's like a bootleg Kevin Samuels. And realistically, nobody else can do Kevin Samuels' show the way Kevin Samuels did his show. I think there's a reason why he sat up there wearing his suits the way he did and the way he had his platform set up, because it eliminated all types of argument. He wearing his suits represents black male authority. And people hated black male authority, but they're also drawn to it as well. There was no excuses. Nobody could say he was a dusty dude because he was always sharp. He always dressed sharp. His setup looked impressive. The way his show looked was impressive. It was, and somebody else could do certain things like this. What this is a blueprint on, you know, what you could do. But realistically, I wouldn't advise any man to sit up here every day unless you were trying to get rich and die, because that's pretty much what happened. I don't blame, you know, anything else on his death. Other than the fact that he overworked himself, according to Dennis Sperling, he was working at least 20 plus hours a day. He only slept for like 3 hours a day or whatever case is. That's not enough sleep. You know, you need at least 6 to 8 hours of sleep. and I don't think he was getting enough sleep. I mean, he was doing his thing, don't get me wrong, and there's no doubt in my mind that when he died rich. You know, he wanted to be successful. He said he wanted to be successful. He said he wanted to get rich off of this, but I bet he had more work in his plans. But unfortunately, you know, he passed away. You know, unfortunately, he overworked himself. I think arguing with bitches every day pretty much put a strain on him. It caused him to age, because if you look at the videos he got out now, or the videos he got out now versus before the average at best video, he had a lot less gray, and he even started to put on some weight. He looked much, you know, slimmer, much fitter, much younger 3 years ago than now that he's, you know, he kind of aged. He's like, he was aging a little bit faster. So arguing with broads every day, I don't blame the Red Bull stuff, because within the Red Bull stuff, you know, I've seen people who worked longer than him and had more stressful environments. They ended up, you know, but at the same time, they could be younger. You know, when they were popping Red Bulls or whatever, they pop a Red Bull and work their 8 hours, and you know, they'll be fine. And they'll be doing that for like a good year or so. And so this is a guy who was doing this for like a year plus. I don't remember seeing him doing the Red Bulls in his previous videos, but I haven't watched all his videos. I don't know, man. It's all still a lot to take in. You know, I'm still processing it, because, you know, I'll get like every once in a while, I'll get like a notification from Instagram that he has a reel up, and then these are like past reels. So I'm like, there's no way he's like still, you know, they've already confirmed it. Like, if I couldn't get any confirmation from any, you know, real media companies, then, you know, Tariq Nasheed had basically given, he had talked about it on his YouTube channel. You know, he confirmed it as well. And I always respect, like, the fact that they had like respect for each other. Even if they didn't agree on certain things, there are certain things that they talked about that's, you know, been similar talking points. And it would have been interesting if, you know, Tariq had did a show of him on his podcast. That would have been interesting. That would have been kind of cool to see them two interacting with each other, just chopping up game like he was on the No Jumper. That would have been like cool to see them just, you know, chopping it up on that level. I forgot the name of his radio show, but he kind of shut it down before the pandemic. But he used to do it with that girl with the two Johns, Bree and I think Layla. And some other Johns, but yeah, he had like a radio show that he used to do. And it would have been interesting to see him up there. Ism Radio, I think that's what it's called. Because I think he had Nipsey Hussle and Michael Jai White up there. Two cats that I pretty much rock with. I enjoyed their work, their content. They were some pretty thorough brothers. But it would have been interesting to see them two chop, Tariq and Kevin chopping up game. A new guy is, you know, on the come up. Sharp from the No Jumper, he's been pretty thorough as well. I always laughed at the fact that he called that Blue Jasmine chick an internet panhandler. That was cracking me up, because that's pretty much what these bras, you know, that's what they sound like. Anyway, I wanted to wrap this up because this has been going on for almost 20 minutes. I didn't think Kevin deserved any of the hate he got. So for people who like to be celebrating his death, that's pretty disgusting, man. That's seriously disgusting. I never thought, like, I might not have agreed with everything that he said. There's some points that he said that I just didn't agree with. But at least he stood on his word. You know, I don't agree with guys having to work. I don't think I agree with guys having to work 60 hours a week. As a matter of fact, I feel like if you need to work that hard, then you're probably not managing your money that correctly. You're not, to be working that hard is putting a lot of stress on you, because you need to enjoy your money. You need to be able to enjoy your money. Yeah, you can make the money, but you also need to enjoy it as well. And that's just one of the things I disagree with. I disagree with certain tricking philosophies. You know, you got to pay your way or pay the cost to be the boss, all that type of stuff. That type of stuff I don't agree with. But just because I didn't agree with him doesn't mean that I gotta you know, attack him or, you know, do all types of disgusting things. I wouldn't celebrate this man's passing because I think he was a good person. You know, I think he was a good dude who was trying to help people, and unfortunately he was gone too soon. I'm going to miss certain things I'm gonna miss about the show is like when a chick would call in and she was asking her what her dress size is and what her height was and, you know, how much the last time she weighed herself, and she'd be like, well, I'm 5'3 and I'm 300 pounds and my dress size is like 23, and he'd be like, he played a Big Shirley sound effect or whatever. That shit used to crack me up. I'm gonna miss that part about the show. Or one of my favorite moments that he had was when this chick called into the show talking about she didn't know what the show was about. So he asked her what was her age, and she said guess, and he was like, he just hung up the phone on her. He was like, guess these nuts. That shit was kind of cool because, man, like I said, a dude in a suit represents authority. A black man in a suit represents black male authority. So, you know, nothing was cooler about his show than the fact that he checked bitches on, like, immediately. He didn't wait until after the show to address something immediately within the moment. And this is something that guys could need to learn when it comes to dealing with females. Don't wait on some passive aggressive shit to check bitches on their bad behavior. You gotta do that shit in the now. You gotta do that shit immediately. So when chicks got out of pocket, you know, he definitely checked them within that moment. You know, it was nothing cooler than seeing him talking to a chick who was just rambling off and then catching all types of attitude, and he would like lay down a law. You know, he would let them know what it was, like, you could keep talking or I'm gonna hang up right now. You know, you could keep, you know, getting out of pocket or I'm gonna hang up right now. It's been a long time since I've seen that type of element on a show. Like, the last time I saw it was like probably Patrice O'Neal when he used to do the Black Phillip show, or when he used to be with Opie and Anthony. And then before that was probably Tariq Nasheed. But so it's been more brothers need to get in that mind frame of just checking bitches within the now. Don't wait later, you know, to get at them. Do that shit within the now. You know, as soon as they do something out of pocket, check that shit in the now. And that was what was cool about that. Here's the thing, is like, I don't look at him passing as a bad thing, because I think he set out to do what he was trying to do. It was probably other things he wanted to do before he died or whatever, and he didn't get a chance to do them. But the fact that he has like a year's worth of content, he has a ton of content. You know, he put out a ton of content. I think he set out to do what he was supposed to do, and, you know, it was just maybe. Unfortunately, it was just his time. I'm hoping to do as much as, if not more, than my goals. You know, I think Sharp had once said, you know, my goal isn't to, you know, worry about, you know, how much money you got or how much more money you're making than me. My goal is to make more money than I had yesterday. And that shit is so fly. So only thing I can really do is worry about my own goals going forward. And I think Kevin was an inspiration, very motivational. And like I said, he's going to be missed. The pros and cons of things is that you can just go to his channel and watch any videos in case you start to miss the, you know, the presence or whatever. It's not going to be the same, but, you know, he's there. You know, you get to study his work and, you know, apply it to your own way of life. Anyway, I want to say rest in peace to Captain Samuels. I send my condolences to his family. I hope everybody else within the Manosphere uses as motivation to keep working, to keep doing your thing, and keep just being awesome, because, you know, we all we got. And I'll catch you guys at the next video. Peace.